In mathematics, we often solve for x, but what about y? Today I want to talk about why the Pythagorean theorem works. This is actually the third proof that I've explored on my channel, but I just think it's really cool to show multiple different paths that can lead to the same destination. There are hundreds of proofs of the Pythagorean theorem out there, but I thought this one was neat because we're using a circle to prove a fact about a triangle. First, we need a circle, and we're going to put a right triangle inside the circle. This triangle will have one side that is the radius of the circle. Then from there, we'll make a line that is perpendicular to the diameter, forming that right angle. We can label the legs of the triangle A and B and call the hypotenuse C. Starting from the top vertex of our triangle and extending to each endpoint of the diameter, we can form two more triangles. We notice on this left triangle, it has two sides that are the length of the radius, or length C, which makes it an isosceles triangle. So then we know these two angles will have the same measure, which we can just call X. And if we know the measures of two angles in our triangle, we can find the third by subtracting them from 180, so this angle will have the measure 180 minus 2x. Now using supplementary angles, we can find this angle of our original right triangle by taking 180 minus this angle that we just found, or in other words, leaving us with 2x. And now we know two angles of our triangle, 90 and 2x, so to find the third, we can subtract from 180 once again and get 90 minus 2x. Now if we look back at this top vertex, we actually know that this forms a right angle, and we know that because of Thales' theorem, which I'm not going to go into depth in this video, but feel free to pause and think about why that might be true, and let me know if you'd like to see a more in-depth video on why that is true. But if we know that these three angles must add up to that 90 degree angle, and we already know the measures of two of those angles, so if we take 90 minus the first angle minus the second angle, that will give us what we're left with for the third angle. So in this case, we would have 90 minus x minus 90 minus 2x, leaving us with x. Now once again, looking at this third triangle, we know the measures of two of the angles because we know it is also a right triangle. So to find the measure of the third angle, we end up with 90 minus x. Now we know that the radius of this circle is c, so to find the length of this side of our third triangle, we can take the radius c, subtract out the length of this bottom side of our original right triangle, and end up with c minus a for the side length of this triangle. So right now, we have some triangles and we found the angles and the side lengths, but remember, our goal is to somehow show a relationship that ends up giving a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So let's look at these three triangles actually as two triangles. We have this bigger triangle here and then our third triangle. It actually turns out that these are similar triangles. And how we can prove that is by looking at the angle measures. They're both right triangles. They both have an angle with measure x. And then if we look at that third angle, we see this one is already 90 minus x. And then if we look at the big triangle and add 90 minus 2x plus x, we also get 90 minus x. So since all three angles in these two triangles are the same, we know that they are similar. Now remember that these triangles are similar, not congruent. This means that their angles all have the same measures, but their side lengths are not necessarily the same. However, we could stretch one up and make them congruent because their side lengths are proportional. Or in other words, we could multiply all of the side lengths by the same number and they would end up matching the other triangle. So in this case, we could set up a proportion of the corresponding sides. So in our case, this might look like C plus A over B equals B over C minus A. So the left side is taking the two legs of our bigger triangle, and the right side is taking the two legs of the smaller right triangle. So now we can do some algebra and see where this gets us. We can multiply both sides by b to get rid of that denominator on the left, leaving us with c plus a equals b squared over c minus a, and do the same thing to get rid of the denominator on the other side. We can multiply both sides by c minus a, leaving us with c plus a times c minus a equals b squared. You can multiply these out using FOIL, or if you think back to the difference of two squares, give you a little shortcut there. It leaves us with c squared minus a squared equals b squared. Add a squared to both sides, and we get c squared equals a squared plus b squared. Or we can rewrite that the way we're more familiar with, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. And since this a, b, and c are corresponding to those side lengths of the right triangle that we made in the very beginning, we have shown that the Pythagorean theorem works. So now, instead of just memorizing it, you have seen at least one method of why this is true. If you're interested in seeing my other videos, I'll link them in the end. Thank you so much for watching. This was What About Why?